that's lost more than $2 million over the past 4 years in spite of steady enrollment. I'm also the managing director for Raise Your Hand for Illinois Public Education. I'm here today to speak about the reality of school budgets, and I'm speaking to you, aldermen. The reality of school budgets at CPS in light of the recent passage of the school funding bill and the need for local revenue to offset the deficit that still exists in CPS. The years of cuts and the new forms of school privatization in the funding bill that will leak more dollars from our public schools. We don't yet know the impact that the tax credit scholarship voucher program will have on CPS, but we do know that CPS has to come up with a significant increase for existing charter schools due to the school funding bill. As WBEZ reported Friday, the charter lobby says they are getting $120 million from CPS due to a mandated increase in per pupil funding. Where is this money going to come from? The reality is that CPS schools are in desperate need of more revenue, and this bill doesn't come close to making our schools whole. This year, CPS has only 138 librarians for 500 district schools, 257 full-time music teachers for 500 schools, 78 full-time foreign language positions for all of our elementary schools, and substandard ratios for school clinicians across the school district. And there's more. Neighborhood high schools have been decimated again. Schurz, Foreman, Julian, Kelly, Dunbar, Marshall, Kelvin Clark, Harlan, Harper, Mather, all lost 10 or more positions. Who is looking out for our most vulnerable students in Chicago? We hope you are. Meanwhile, TIFs have brought in a record $561 million this year. Where is the urgency from this body to use more of that money to fund our schools? Why hasn't this body debated revenue options for our schools? Why hasn't the corporate head tax ordinance at least been debated? It is your job to debate these issues. It is your job to take action on these issues so that your constituents know where you stand